Hello everybody, my name is PCL Jamaa and thank you for clicking on this video. Today's video is going to be about how I make Animal Jam videos and how you can make Animal Jam videos. Be sure to subscribe to my channel, you don't have to, but it helps me out, so it would be a nice gesture. Anyways, I'm just going to get started now. So, the first thing you are going to need is an editor. Editing your videos is a really good idea if you want to make your videos look nice, give it a nice touch, and if you want to find your own editing style that other people won't be able to have. Two free editors that I highly recommend are iMovie and HitFilm 4 Express. HitFilm 4 Express is a free editor to Windows users. I recommend it. It is like Camtasia, but it's free, you know? And it's good for making basic videos. Same with iMovie. Plenty of people use iMovie and it's a great editor. I recommend it. And the outcome of people's videos in iMovie are really nice. There are more advanced editors such as Camtasia, Filmora, but those aren't very advanced editors, which is why I like them. I use Camtasia and I have no regrets. I really like Camtasia, especially since it has a screen recorder built into it. The only cons of Filmora and Camtasia is that they are expensive. They do cost money. However, what's nice about Camtasia, for the least, is that once you buy it, you can use it to your heart's content because it is not a subscription, it is a one-time purchase. As for other editors like After Effects, Sony Vegas Pro, Final Cut Pro, those are more expensive editors, however, they are more advanced, so if you are willing to commit to being a legitimate Animal Jam editor who makes like MEP parts and AJMVs, then you might want to invest in one of those. Anyways, that's all for editors. I think we can move on to the next tip. The next thing you are going to need to make Animal Jam videos is a microphone. Now, this is actually optional. I know plenty of people who do not talk in their videos, you may be one. But if you do plan on talking in your videos, you're gonna want a mic. So, some microphones I recommend are really just any of Blue's microphones, Blue Microphone Company. I use a Blue Yeti, I have no regrets, it is a great editor, it is easy to use, and the sound quality is really nice. The Blue Snowball is also a microphone by Blue. It is very good quality and it's also a great microphone. And it's a lot cheaper than the Blue Yeti, which is I think 120 bucks. So if you're willing to go a little cheaper, then I recommend the Blue Snowball, which still isn't that cheap. It's quite expensive, but that's the reality of microphones. But if you are on a budget, then you can always just use a built-in microphone to your computer. My computer actually does not have a built-in microphone, so I actually have to use a legitimate microphone. But if your computer has a microphone built into it, you can always use that. And then again, like I said earlier, you don't even have to use a microphone. If you want, you can just put text over your videos, and that would work really nicely as well. I'm going to actually dedicate an entire section in this video to music. Music is an important part in making your videos entertaining. Sometimes your voice isn't enough, or sometimes just text on a screen isn't enough to keep viewers in your video. Background music is a great way to keep them hooked, and I use background music a lot. So the type of music you want to use in the background of your videos really depends if you're talking in your video or not. If you are talking in your video, then it's a good idea to not put music with lyrics in your video because the lyrics of the song is going to block out your voice and it's overall just gonna create a messy outcome, which you do not want. There's a YouTube library filled with different songs, copyright-free songs that you can use in the background of your videos that won't override your voice. And if you're not talking in your videos, you can always use whatever music you want. Just be careful because that brings me to copyright music. If you use copyright music, there is a chance that your video will become blocked in certain countries, and that's not a good thing because you want everyone around the world to be able to watch your content. So yeah, I break that rule quite often though. I use copyright music in my AJMVs, so hopefully my AJMVs aren't blocked in most countries, but maybe they are. I really hope not, but they probably are. In order to make a good video, I think it's a great idea to have a plan. When you plan your videos, the outcome is a lot more organized and you're just gonna be more satisfied. And yes, I know, planning your videos can be annoying sometimes. You want to get straight to filming and editing, and you don't wanna have to go through the process of planning out what you're gonna say, what you're gonna do in your video. But trust me, planning out your videos is going to help you so much. Like this video I'm making right now, I planned out all the tips I was gonna share with you guys. I planned out most of what I was gonna say. So I think that planning your videos really helps you make good videos. I know it's tedious, but trust me, it's worth it. The next thing you need is commitment. Now, I know maintaining commitment is hard, and although it sounds easy, it is hard. Because some of us have social lives, we have friends, we have activities, we have school. Right now it's summer, but we do have school. So maintaining commitment isn't as easy as it sounds. To stay committed, it's a good idea to have an editing schedule, or rather an uploading schedule, I should say. I don't have a schedule, that's probably not a good thing. But what a schedule is going to do is it's going to remind you every time, oh, I need to upload a video. But again, with your schedule, don't push yourself. Try to upload about 2 times a week. I only upload like once a week, but because it's the summer, I'm probably gonna change that. I'm probably gonna be a lot more active. You're gonna need to stay committed, and commitment is the number one key component. I'm sure there are plenty of other tips, but the last tip I'm going to be sharing with y'all is thumbnails. You need to make thumbnails for your videos because thumbnails are what's going to attract your viewers to your videos. Would you rather see a video with an adorable thumbnail, or would you rather see a video with a suggested thumbnail? The suggested thumbnails aren't always the best. I mean, they can be, but like, it's better to just make your own thumbnails. I use picmonkey.com to make my thumbnails. The only problem is that it's not free anymore. It really sucks because PicMonkey used to be free and it's great, but now it's not free for some reason. But a cheat that everyone does is they use PicMonkey and then they just screenshot the thumbnail that they made, so you can still use PicMonkey if you want. Thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you in my next video, or at least you will hear me in your next video. I'm sorry. And yeah, overall, just thank you so much for watching my video. All right, goodbye.